Joining me now, Congresswoman Maxine Waters, Democrat from California. And Congresswoman, the last time you were on the show, you had extremely strong words for the Trump campaign folks. You used the Kremlin clan. You called them scumbags, I believe. There was some blowback for that. I'm curious if you how you feel about those comments now before we get into the latest developments.
Well, we've had a lot of supporters who are thrilled with the fact that I am, you know, just so forthcoming about how I feel. Of course, there are some people who don't like it, but I feel fine. I'm absolutely fine. I'm going to continue to do my work, to do everything that I possibly can to help connect the dots, to help encourage independent investigation or commission. I'm going to do everything that I can to keep my colleagues interested enough to want to fight to see exactly what happened, because I believe that there was a connection between Donald Trump's campaign and the Russians and the Kremlin, and I do believe that those connections are there for a reason. And I think that the work that has already been discovered that was done in order to help Trump should be followed up. We shouldn't say, let our intelligence agency say, yes, we discovered that the DNC was hacked and that efforts were made to help Trump in this campaign and to undermine Hillary Clinton, and that's it. We don't have to do anything else. No. This is serious, and I think that we must continue this struggle to dig deeper, to drill deeper. I think there is a trail, and I think that the Obama administration has done everything that it can possibly do, and that's probably been verified somewhat by the New York Times, to make sure that enough people have seen some of the meetings and some of the connections so that they have something to go on when the investigations are really underway.
When you talk about digging, I want to just be clear here. My understanding is your position is that Jeff Sessions should resign, given that he and that there should be an independent commission. Given that he has recused himself from this matter, should there be an appointment of special counsel to oversee whatever investigations may be happening?
Well, I think so. I think that would be extremely helpful. What we know is that we can't trust the AG. We can't trust the FBI. We can't trust Comey. We can't trust Sessions. And so we've got to get an independent overseer of some kind in here to get going with these investigations.
So you would like to see, so it's not only just an appointment, a special counsel, of course, would be within the DOJ power structure, but you also want to, you, like your colleagues, want a 9/11 style commission with subpoena power to be impaneled through some sort of legislation to investigate this.
Well, absolutely. I mean, I think we're going to have to do everything that we possibly can to take the investigations out of the House and even out of the Senate, even though I have more more feelings about it being in the House and not thinking that it can really be credible than I do in the Senate. I do think that we
I want to make sure I'm understanding that. You trust the Senate more than you trust the House in terms of the relative, the two committees now working on it, the intelligence
and absolutely. Stuff. Absolutely. And I trust that the Intelligence Committee of the Senate is more serious about looking at this. And I want to tell you, I really do trust John McCain and Lindsey to help make sure that something serious is done to get to the bottom of this on the Senate side.
Is this because you don't trust Devin Nunes, who's the chair on the House side?
Well, yeah, basically, I don't trust the Republicans on the House side.
Okay. Congresswoman Maxine Waters with kind words for John McCain and Lindsey Graham. It's a strange time we live in. Thank you for your time. Appreciate it.